This video is brought to you by Squarespace. We are in the Final Cut Pro interface, and today we're gonna work very simply to create the effects that you saw in the beginning of this video by just using the blend mode that you can see in the inspector panel here on the right. So let's see how we did the first one. Here we started. So what we need to do is to have two different separate layers. So I'm gonna select the B in my keyboard so I can blade this, and then I'm gonna press A to select it, and by holding the Option or Alt on my keyboard, I will click and duplicate it so I can place it above it. Now I will go into the inspector panel. I will change the blend mode to lighten, and also I will change the blend mode to lighten on the footage below. And now what we can do is that we can go again to the inspector panel and we can change the transform tool, so we can scale it. And we can click here to select it and place it either left or right. Let's say we want to place it here on the right. And press done. Now, also we can change the opacity, so we can play with the opacity to see exactly how much we want for it to be. So let's say about 70%. Would be an ideal for this effect, and simply as that we have the first effect. For the second, again I'm dragging this with the Option and the click so I can duplicate it. Now let's play with a different blend mode. Let's see the hard light, and also let me scale it a little bit so we can see the difference. Let's change the opacity to 50%, and let's leave it here in the center to begin with. And here let's blade it. I'm selecting B on my keyboard, blading these so we can change with a different one. Now you saw that on the bottom layer I didn't change the blend modes, so we select this. Let's go to an exclusion. Okay, difference, perfect. That's very nice. And we can grab this now and place it here on the left. Let's see. I can also lower a little bit the opacity, because you know I always like to mix things up. I can zoom in here now and create a transition. Now let me talk a little bit about Squarespace. If you don't know who Squarespace is an all-in-one platform where you can get your domain or build your own website. With Squarespace you can very easily choose from templates that you can use them as a structure and start building your website without having any knowledge at all at web design and web development. So if you're a creator and you don't have a website, something that is a must, you can head over to squarespace.com/Emilio. You can try it for free first, and when you're ready to buy, you can use the coupon code Emilio and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Now let's go back into the video. How we're gonna do that, for those who watch the channel, you already know that I like to use the blade tool and break frame by frame, moving with the right key on my keyboard. I'm breaking this to one layer at a time. So one step to the right and blading, one step to the right and blading. And I'm gonna delete this, and I'm gonna delete this one, this one, this one, and this one. And you can see that we can move from this footage to the next one. And let's see what we can do with this layer here. Again, I'm gonna press Option to duplicate it. I'm gonna go to the blend mode, select the screen and also screen on the bottom. Okay, I'm gonna have this a little bit to the right again. I'm making more of a zoom in this time. And I'm gonna set the opacity to 100% for this one. So check this out. And for the last one, again, option and left click so I can duplicate it. Now, what I wanna do is I'm gonna change the blend mode, let's say to add this time, and then I'm gonna add a keyframe on the scale all. Now, I'm gonna let it play a little bit. I'm gonna make a zoom here to, let's say, 260, as you see right here on the inspector panel. I'm gonna leave it play a little bit again. Then I'm gonna add another keyframe to scale, and I'm gonna add a keyframe to position as well. Gonna leave it play a little bit, and then I'm gonna change the scale even more, and now I'm gonna change the position as well. I'm gonna leave it play a little bit. I'm gonna add another keyframe to scale and to position. Leave it play a little bit. I'm gonna change again the scale and the position. I'm gonna make it a little bit lower. Let's check what the result is gonna be on this one. So remember, you can do different adjustments to the transform when you're using the blend mode as well, or you can leave it simply as that, just the blend mode. You can be as much creative as you want. Remember, I'm giving you the keys to unlock the doors of your own creativity. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, don't forget to like it, and also if you have any questions, I'm waiting you in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video.